Hello there. Okay, so I had it scheduled in my planner to wake up early in the morning so I could head over to open my PO box and also print out the information I need for my passport for my appointment. Oh, there it is. I freaked out. I was like, where is my information? For my passport tomorrow? Yeah, tomorrow. For the new year, I'm gonna either these shoes that my mom got me for Christmas are gonna be my main shoes. So I'm outside the UPS, right? Plan is kind of sort of derailed. I mean, we're still good to go, right? But I came at what, 8:30 or so, or 8 or so, and apparently it doesn't open until 9. Okay. And I'll still make it in time to call, but a little off schedule, aren't we?
Success! I have my PO box keys. Now we're just waiting for my.
All right, sorry, I'm back home. The Uber came very, very fast, so I was interrupted. But I'm home. I have my PO box. I have the application for the US passport. It is 9:26, 9:27 now. And yeah. Let's hit the phones, make some calls. Hi, just want to log in that I am at the dentist right now. What am I doing at the dentist? Yes, I am getting this Invisalign out. I'm getting it. Well, yeah, this is my last tray of Invisalign. Hopefully, when I go in, they'll see everything okay to start the process of me wearing retainers and I can finally walk this world without this and speak without a lisp. So let me rant to you about my life, okay? So I Ubered over here from where? From where? Right, from the dentist to over here, which is the UPS, where I had scheduled an appointment for a passport, okay? And this is going to be the price, as it seems, is going to come up to 145. No, sorry, 245. Around that price, right? The price of the passport, the expedited shipping, no, the expedited processing, and the which is the fastest I could choose. The email when I confirmed my appointment said that I cannot be able to purchase my passport through a debit card. Okay. Right, and it says something about using the money order at UPS to do it. So I went into UPS. It's like 1 o'clock, right? It's 1:18, and I'm here very early. My appointments are like 2 or 3 or whatever. And yeah, I asked for a money order of 250 in case some extra fees come in my face. And I sort of like explain like throughout there that I'm applying for a passport. I know you can't pay debit card, so money order of 250, please. And the lady before was like, the lady beside him was like, "What's your name, Genosha?" So she saw my name on the application, not on the application, on the schedule. I do have an appointment soon with them, and they said, "Oh no, we'll do it all at once." Because, and then he made a comment saying, "Oh, 250 is kind of weird for a money order." Like, I don't know what he means by that. So like I sort of like reiterated, I understand that you can't pay with debit card, so I would like to get the money order now. And they said, "Oh no, it's okay. We'll do it all at once." So that's what I was told. And I don't understand why 250 is weird if I need 240 something to get this passport. I can't pay cash. I can't pay card either. I don't know what's going on, you guys, but I'll take their word for it. Hopefully, when I sit there with my application and stuff, things go smooth. So I really want to get my eyebrows done, and there's an eyebrow place down there. So I'll go do that, and I will read more of the book I'm reading. Yeah, Forever Amber. You guys, look at my brows. She didn't really ask how I want it. She just went at it, and I forgot to like assert myself again. But she made it like too straight. Like, I always want an arch going on, you know? I don't know. Nor did she seem to like wax off the wax properly because every time I blink, my eyelashes keep sticking over to up here. Yeah, there's some wax up here.
And what's this oil? No. No, honey.
I have everything. I have the application. I have the photocopies. I made an appointment and I'm there. I'm ready to fucking go. Okay? My birth certificate is fucking laminated. It's laminated by my parents since I was a fucking baby, which is not their fault. I don't know. They don't know any better. You don't laminate U.S. certificates. It's not valid. Whatever, 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 the fuck, whatever. And I was on the side at the USPS, like, trying to get the limitation off. Of course, it didn't come off. And she gave me some advice on how I can get another certificate, but the fact that it's the U.S. Virgin Islands, like, she doesn't know if I have to reorder it directly from the U.S. Virgin Islands, or if I have to, if I can just walk into an office and get it. Like, who the fuck knows? And how long is it gonna take? Because I have to go.
Hello, hello. I'm back home, and I did a bit of reading, so more calm. And I was looking up how you can get rid of laminated documents successfully. And one of the things it said was, what did it say? Hey, let's go. Let's do this. It said that I can use a blow dryer, well, something that involves a blow dryer. And lucky for me, I had thought to pack a blow dryer when I left.
All right, so I have the birth certificate. I have the hair dryer and a fork that I predict will help with the peeling. So, unload.
Okay, so what's happening now is it's 6:34 and I was just in the, whatchamacallit, what the hell even is this? Did I lose it already? Oh well, the Virgin Islands, United States, yeah, the Virgin Island of United States, Department of Health, whatever, whatever, Office of Vital Records and Statistics, and in the website, it says it gave me an application for a certified copy of birth records. It's a PDF, okay? It's a PDF, and the PDF needs a notary. So what I'm doing, well, where is it now? Are you kidding me? Yeah, what I'm doing is scheduling for tomorrow at 10 a.m. Continue. To get a notary at the UPS store.
So here's the agenda for tomorrow. I'm gonna wake up early at 9 a.m. I'm going to go to the UPS store to print the application for my vital record, a birth certificate. Okay, at 10 a.m. I'm going to, I think 10 a.m. I think it's the same UPS store to notarize the application. 11 a.m. I'm going to go down to the UPS and then the money order mail application. Yes, for the money orders that's needed, and I'm going to mail the application. And it's important that it's in the same place because apparently to mail the application, I need a money order from here. Okay. And then I'm going to use, listen, when you're sending the application, they want like the photocopy of your driver's license. And that's interesting because also to get the passport, I need a photocopy. So I'm going to have to like reprint a photocopy, you know. I also have an order for soap. So hopefully when I'm at pickup order, at UPS, so I'm gonna add that to what I need to do. Okay,
I am outside the UPS store waiting to print out what I need to print out and hopefully get that papers to St. Croix.
Listen, I got it notarized, okay, but the UPS that I picked is not the UPS, no, the, yes, is not the UPS that was beside the USPS of choice, okay? But there is a 19-minute walk to the USPS, oh Jesus freaking Christ, to the USPS, another USPS, for me to mail this document along with getting the money order. So I suppose I will do that. I will
go to that USPS, I'll fill this out. He notarized it even though it was not filled out. And yeah, I think we're good. That's the plan. So I'm gonna head up and walk out.
So I'm at the USPS, trying to fill out application for certified copy of birth record, right? And the only thing left missing is father's physical address at time of birth of person whose record is required. What? Am I supposed to remember an address from 20 years ago from my father, who's in all the way in a different country I can't contact? And my mother doesn't remember the exact address. No one remembers. And their address is somewhere in Antigua. Can I put Antigua? I'm gonna put Antigua. And that better be enough. Don't ask me for the exact address. No one knows the exact address, weirdos. So what I wanna do, I want to call 340-714-1311. Express concern about the physical address thing and figure out like how long till I get back this document, I guess, that I need from them. Do you hear that? Useless. So listen, I am back home, okay? I did walk over to the UPS. No, you saw me. I took footage. I have footage, okay? So you saw me there. And when I went to the counter to ask for the money order, there was no money order. They didn't have any. And she gave me advice of where I can get one, like Fresco or whatever, but I just Ubered home. And mind you, when I was walking out, then I saw, you know, that makeshift sign on the door saying that they don't have any money orders. Okay. I just Ubered home because my phone was at like 5% and I just knew it was not gonna make it. Me finding this place, getting the money order, and knowing how the hell I'm gonna go back home, it's not gonna come together too well. So I'm back home. It's 10:50. Last time I checked, I don't know, is it 11 now? Yeah, it's 11:02 right now. Okay, and maybe what will happen is the phone will give it an hour, like 12, and then I'll go back out there. I'll go to the other USPS, the ones I planned to originally go to, right? Get my soaps, get my order from there, and hopefully they have money orders. And yeah, maybe things can go smoothly over there. I'm here. I'm just checking over what I need, right? United States post money order 15, court order amendment additional 30. Okay. I'm not really sure what a money order is, you guys, but we're gonna find out, okay? So I have the money orders, okay? Now it's just about filling this the hell out. It's 1:10. Okay, we have time. Going to get a copy of my driver's license. Hi, so I have a receipt for the envelope I just sent to my birth island, St. Croix. Do I think I'll receive the certificate in time to apply for the passport? Barely. I'm gonna need that birth certificate some way or another, especially for international travel. So might as well start the process for it now amidst all my frustrations, then later. And you know what I'm absolutely forgetting? The soaps. I forgot my soaps. So let me go back into the USPS and see. I don't think it's in the P.O. box, you know. I don't have the key. I forgot that key. I do feel like it's being on hold by the peoples. So I'm gonna see if that's the case. I've heard of one of these. I should put a book in here.
Physically in all of the illies, I am really enjoying this cringy ass video.
Hello there. So, it's January 9th, okay? And I basically figured out a long time ago, well, like 2 days ago, that I don't really need my passport to have the travel, to have the trip, to the work trip to Colorado. You know, I just need my driver's license. I think that's what I read. I think I researched it 3 times just to be sure, but no, I just need my driver's license, right? And when I found that out,
online, like all the stress drain from my body, but not for long because there's new stressors, right? Number one, I am curious about the information I sent out for my birth certificate, right? You know, eventually I'm gonna need my passport for international travel, so it works that I could at least get a viable birth certificate on my hands. And I'm still curious to see how I filled it out would actually work out, like they were able to find this thing and I'll be able to submit it for a passport card or a passport, whatever works, right? Another thing that's on my mind is I am expected to have 4 deals closed by the end of the month, so I'm feeling the heat. I shouldn't. So and hopefully you know what I mean by that. I gotta into this right now, and I will. Okay. Another thing is the apartment situation. Basically, I need like $2,000 to get the keys to new apartment, and it as it seems, I would not be able to get the $2,000 by the due time. And she said that then I could just move the move-in time to the 26th. Okay, but where am I gonna stay up until 26th, right? And I'm hoping, I'm really not trying to stay. Like, then I have to like shelf off like another like $600 for another Airbnb for 2 weeks while I have the funds to hop into this new location, right? There's that in my head. Or I can call my mom and see if she would let me stay in her place for 2 weeks until I move in. It's a good situation, but I don't want to do that either. My pride wants, the way my pride is set up right now, I want to be completely independent. And even if it's facing the misery of a low bank account balance, then I'll just do it and think about how I can avoid that for the rest of my life. And I hate to think that way because I have to, my hair is overgrown, my nails, my winter nails, right, is overgrown, and I got my brows done, but these are freaking horrible. Like, it's not giving the way it's supposed to give, and that's my fault. I should have spoke up, but that's the update of where I am. that's the first few weeks of 2024, but I'm trying out here, and the only thing I can do is try, right? I don't have a lot, okay, but for now I have my health, I have my job, I have I can call upon discipline, I can develop more discipline, I can develop skill, and that will get me through, right? That's already understood, but it's just more highlighted in this mind more than ever. And I wish I had a more entertaining video to give you, right? But this is just where I am right now, you know, trying to really make this my era of productivity.